Hello, I'm Ryan Deacon.
And I'm Danielle Farrar. We're from the Research and Exploratory Development Department and here to show you how we use some of the tools in the electron microscopy facility. This is a scanning electron microscope, or SEM. As the name implies, it uses a highly focused beam of electrons to examine samples. We use this instrument to create extremely high magnification images of things like biological specimen, nanomaterials, and microstructures.
The SEM is also equipped with specialized tools that extend its functionality far beyond imaging. One of these tools is energy dispersion spectroscopy, or EDS, which helps us to analyze the chemical composition of a sample. This technique is valuable, for example, when we're conducting a failure analysis. Identifying the contaminants on a fractured component can help determine the cause of failure. Another SEM tool involves the use of electron backscatter diffraction. EBSD provides information about the crystal structure, that is, the arrangement of atoms within a material. This is important because that specific arrangement determines a wide range of materials' properties, such as strength, toughness, or hardness. The EBSD technique can also differentiate between compounds that have a similar composition but different crystal structure. For example, one of the most commonly used titanium alloys, Ti64, can have two different crystal structures called phases. The atoms for one phase are arranged in a cube, while in another they are arranged in a hexagon. The amount of each phase present in a component made from this alloy will strongly impact the overall performance of its ultimate application. So EBSD lets us determine how much of each phase we have, and therefore characterize the final material properties of the component.
One of our newest SEM tools, electron beam lithography, uses a narrow beam of electrons to write lines, traces, and other patterns onto substrates in order to fabricate micro or nanoscale features. This technique is being used to drive the next generation of microelectronic devices that are small enough to fit on the edge of a piece of paper. With EBL, we can easily and affordably create the next generation of wireless implantable devices, provide ways to measure electrical properties at the nanoscale, and offer techniques for conducting electron transport studies of semiconductor interfaces, most of which would be quite challenging, if not impossible, to accomplish with traditional lithography methods or conventional tools. From imaging nanoparticles to producing advanced nanoelectronic devices, APL's electron microscopy facility provides a wealth of valuable information to our customers. The combination of high magnification and high resolution imaging, compositional and structural analysis, and electron beam-based fabrication creates enormous opportunities to develop advanced materials.